Once, there were four children called Peter, Susan, Edmund, and Lucy. They were sent away from London during the Second World War to the house of a kind old professor who lived in the country. On the first morning, the children decided to explore the big house. It was full of interesting things and unexpected places. One room had a suit of armor in it. Another, all hung with green, had a harp in the corner. And one room was quite empty, except for a big wardrobe with a looking glass in the door. "Nothing there," said Peter, and they all trooped out again. All except Lucy. Opening the wardrobe door, she saw several long fur coats hanging up and immediately got in amongst them. As she went further in, she noticed to her surprise that the soft furs began to feel rough and prickly, just like the branches of trees. A moment later, she was standing in the middle of a wood with snow under her feet and snowflakes falling through the air. Lucy felt a little frightened, but very excited too. Ahead of her, between the dark tree trunks, a light was shining. She walked towards it, crunch, crunch over the snow. It was a lamppost. As Lucy stood, wondering why there was a lamppost in the middle of a wood, she heard a pitter-patter of feet, and then a very strange person stepped out from among the trees. From the waist upwards, he was like a man, but his legs were shaped like a goat's. He had a pleasant little face and curly hair, out of which stuck two horns. He was a faun. When he saw Lucy, he gave a start of surprise. "Good evening," said Lucy. "Good evening," said the faun. "Excuse me, but are you a daughter of Eve?" "My name is Lucy," she said, not quite understanding him. "But forgive me, are you what they call a girl?" he asked. "Of course I am," replied Lucy, thinking his questions very strange. "I have never seen a son of Adam or a daughter of Eve before," said the faun. "I'm delighted to meet you. My name is Tumnus." "I'm very pleased to meet you, Mr. Tumnus," said Lucy. "And may I ask, O Lucy, daughter of Eve," said Mr. Tumnus, "how you have come into Narnia?" "Narnia? What is that?" said Lucy. "This is the land of Narnia," said the faun. "Everything that lies between the lamppost and the great castle of Caer Paravel on the eastern sea. I got in through the wardrobe in the spare room," said Lucy. "Ah," said Mr. Faun, "if only I had worked harder at geography when I was a little faun, I should know all about these strange countries." "But they aren't countries at all," said Lucy, almost laughing. "It's only just back there. It is summer there." "Meanwhile," said Mr. Tumnus, "it is winter in Narnia, and has been for ever so long, and we shall both catch cold if we stand here talking in the snow. Daughter of Eve, from the far land of Spare Oom, would you like to come and have tea with me?" "I'd like that very much," said Lucy, who was feeling quite hungry, "but I won't be able to stay long." And so Lucy found herself walking through the wood arm in arm with the fawn, as if they had known each other all their lives.